The eyes to the right, 278. The nose to the left, zero.
The eyes have it. The eyes have it. Unlock.
2016年4月20号，英国下议院全票通过，定性叙利亚和伊拉克的雅兹迪人、基督徒等少数族裔的遭遇为种族清洗。多位议员在投票前的发言都提到，在前一天的闭门听证会上，伊贝特和女儿杰克林所带来的叙利亚影片，以及曾经遭受伊斯兰国侵害的 D-Class 提供了极有说服力的证据。
Jacqueline spoke of the shock of the fear of the knock on the door by fighters from Daesh.
In 下议院投票之前一个月，上议院否决了定性伊斯兰国行为是种族清洗的提案。能够在短短时间之内有戏剧性的转变， Jacqueline 见到是由一连串的事件促成。
That same week.I was sitting in a cafe, and I was doing my work, and I looked outside the window, and I saw a protest. When I walked to see what the protest was about, I found that out of all topics, it was on the refugee crisis. And I knew that I had been at that cafe at that moment for a reason. And I saw a woman on stage, and she was screaming, she was crying out, "These are our sisters, can't you see? They're not just numbers, they're faces."And my heart was just beating. And I knew that I had to connect with this woman.
They will each serve a two-year term.
Jacqueline 留下自己的背景和资料，当晚就收到一位政客的回应。
Well, he connects me via email to have an interview live on the most watched television show in the United Kingdom. That night, I spoke my heart out.Well, again, not coincidentally, one of the gentlemen that tried to get this vote passed in the right direction turned on the television that night, and he saw me on TV making that pitch. And at that moment, he decided, I'm not going to give up. He connects with me and asks me to come and testify, this time not in the House of Lords, but in the House that counts, where the vote truly counts,The House of Commons, and he asked me to bring two witnesses.
Jacqueline 随即联系之前在德国难民营探访的雅兹迪女孩 Eklas, 透过英国国会安排的特别签证前往伦敦。同时，她也想起当时正身处叙利亚拍摄的 Yvette.
The third, again, I always say not coincidentally, was my mother, and I told the Member of Parliament if.By a miracle, she is able to get out, and she's able to come out with the footage. She can come and testify. They thought, they said that it would be perfect. Someone that just comes from Syria with fresh evidence, what more do we want? They saw her.Symbolizing the mothers who had lost their children. They saw Ikhlas, the rescued girl, who symbolized their daughters who had lost their dignity and their honor because of a crime that was forced upon them. And I was connecting the dots. And it was at that moment that they took the initiative and they realized that this was not just an ordinary vote.
将每一个受害者看为自己的儿女，看为自己的父母，使人更加体会受害者的感受，理解他们的需要，回应他们的呼求。
We must stand up and support the call.
I think we could have done much more.
在国会下议院投票决议之后。英国积极在联合国层面推动国际合作，当中包括及时保留多处乱葬岗，作为伊斯兰国种族清洗的罪证。
We heard the tears of a young girl.
Jacqueline 相信， 恐怖组织应当被送上国际刑事法庭，以使受到洗脑的人明白真相，使受害者得到公道、尊严、赔偿以及长远援助，得以返回家乡。
Many times I've asked survivors, what will it take for you to go back? And they say again and again, we will go back knowing that the world has stood up to keep us safe. Practical ways. Establish a court and prosecute them, one. Establish a safe zone for us, two. Provide us what we need to restore our lives again, three.Sometimes it's hard for individuals to do that alone. But if the great powers come together, they'll give the minorities a chance to preserve their ancient civilizations that are now in danger of becoming extinct.
This is a call for action.
As an official language,
to make Christians... 为此 Yvette 和 Jacqueline 积极争取联合国、欧盟以及世界上有影响力的大国一同起来行动，使局势向人性人道的路径发展。
And that their grandchildren and great grandchildren one day would be studying about this moment in their history books, and they would ask the question, "What did you do when this was happening? What did you do when innocent people?" were being massacred and raped and robbed based upon what they believed.
国家层面的行动可以左右大局，而每个人都起来行动也可以发挥不可忽视的力量。在美国、香港、新加坡等地方，以外他多次向华人分享，争取这个有影响力的群体回应叙利亚的呼声。
But I'm telling you, this is all of our solution together. We are all the solution.
As China is one of the member states of the United Nations Security Council and is a permanent member, it is very important that we display the truth and bring awareness of what's happening into Asia. Because China plays such a role.That it's very important for its audiences, the audiences throughout Asia, to know what's happening and to reach out to its government officials.
Yvette 也连同华人电视台创世电视，将受害者的真实经历制作成电视纪录片，将新闻以外的实情透过大众媒体广播，在华人地区和美国唤起更多关注。
We've seen Creation TV's passion.Dedication and heart for the minorities suffering in that part of the world. With the heart and the influence, you can make a change in this world.
His purpose to be his voice and to be the voice for the voiceless, to bring the people of God together, to bring the world, to bring the government, to start to stand against evil and to bring the love of Christ.To the people who are hurting.
Yvette 和 Jacqueline 也摸索不同的实际方法去帮助受害者。其中，名为 Take Over Trauma 的项目，在不同国家募集二手电脑和智能电话，送到受害者手中，透过网络心理辅导。为这些身心受创甚至曾经沦为性奴隶的人解开心结。
Freedom comes with the responsibility to help others. Because if I wasn't born in America, if I was born in Syria or Iraq today, I wouldn't have the opportunities I have. I wouldn't have the protection to know that I was safe. And with that comes such a responsibility to know that the only difference between myself and them is that I was born somewhere else.
同住地球村，同为受造之人，看到人困苦流离，感同身受，心生怜悯。许多人已经起来行动，还有什么借口让你不伸出援手？埃及，2017年2月，西奈半岛有基督徒社群，接连受到伊斯兰国分支的袭击，幸存的80多个家庭逃离家园。4月9号，两个埃及北部城市先后有基督教堂发生自杀式炸弹袭击，47人死亡，137人受伤。叙利亚，2017年4月4号，毒气攻击夺去86人性命。4月15号，有汽车用食物引来儿童，随后爆炸，126人死亡。北欧瑞典，一个曾经发表支持伊斯兰国言论的男人，在4月7号劫持汽车，撞入首都闹市的购物中心，造成4人丧生，多人受伤。5月，菲律宾南部的马拉维市，被声称效忠伊斯兰国的组织占领，挟持平民与政府军交火，截止到2017年8月，事件仍未平息。土耳其、尼日利亚、利比亚，甚至欧盟总部所在的比利时布鲁塞尔，都被视为恐怖主义的温床。恐怖主义的威胁已经蔓延全球，夺命袭击随时发生。为明天，为人道，为发出呼声的受害者，一同起来行动。信仰会胜过绝望，力量随着感慨去探访，急需你在旁，你牵下的肩膀，面对生死。时候到了，每个人都需采取一个立场，它不安全，无利益，不合潮流，却是每个人都必须采取的，因为良心告诉你，这是当行之事。